NicknLex here.
Hey everyone!
How's it going, guys? So, tonight, we're gonna do a marathon for... Who is it? Who's the lucky one?
The marathon is for Bird in Hand. Thank you so much.
She was in charge.
Thank you so much to Bird in Hand for this marathon and for all of your support. I was really excited when this one came in and I saw ELO. I just love them. We've only done one song together, Mr. Right. Blue Sky. So,
Yeah. And I did a marathon by myself. What? And then I think I did ELO in another marathon, but just one song. But I did an entire marathon.
I know. With ELO. I remember you telling me about that. And mm-hmm. I was like, well, it's okay. We have an ELO marathon ourselves coming up. So very excited about that. Thank you so much again to Bird in Hand. And this is a very cool one because we're going to do from the album On the Third Day, 1973. The first four tracks of the album. So those are what he requested. Ocean Breakup / King of the Universe. Bluebird is Dead. Oh No, Not Susan. And New World Rising, Ocean Breakup Reprise.
Nice.
So very, very cool. I can't wait. Yeah. I know I'm going to have a lot of fun with this.
Yes. No. I mean, I just love... I was gonna say Emerson, and Palmer. No, Electric Light Orchestra. And the marathon that I did was so much fun. And I did say, like, I don't know if you heard in the comment section that a lot of people were like, yeah, they're like the Beatles.
Yes,
the Beatles
yes.
Stuck together. Mm-hmm. And so I guess, and I don't know if that's gonna be the same case on this album, but hey.
Yeah, because that one was specifically designed to have Beatlesque songs, totally. Right? Yeah. I love that. Mm-hmm. Very, very cool marathon ideas that you guys come up with. I love seeing them. And so let's get started. On the Third Day, ELO.
Let's do it.
Ocean Breakup.
We're ready. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
Thank you for the support. Thank you, Bird in Hand, for waiting this long. Mm-hmm. You know, I know it's been a long road to this day, but we're finally basically we're almost done with everything.
Yes,
and then
almost
we can reopen the requests for Nick and Lex together, and it's gonna be a lot of fun. So first song, here we go, and you guys have fun. Mm-hmm. And here we go. Wow.
wonder if it's gonna bleed over.
Yeah, me too.
If it does, let's let it.
We can stop.
Amazing.
I love the opening. It was like
it was so cinematic. Stupid. Yeah, because I was like listening to them, like, this is very orchestral, and I'm like,
they literally in the comment section it said, I didn't know this, by the way, that they had an orchestra, because I thought they were called Electric Light Orchestra.
Okay.
But they literally always play with an orchestra.
Wow, that's amazing.
So, yeah, that's why there's so
much. That must be a cool band to watch live. Okay. So, yeah, that explains all the sounds and the depth of, like, the music.
It sounds a lot like Supertramp all of a sudden, because it's very piano-driven, but a lot of string instruments. Mm-hmm. And then at the beginning was like ba ba da 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 ba da ba ba da 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 ba da. Does that remind you of something? It reminds me of something.
It reminds me. I don't know.
Like, I don't know if I've heard it in a movie or.
Mm-hmm. Like a theme of some sort. Uh-huh. Totally. I can, yeah.
Maybe a classical piece. Mm-hmm.
I could see that for sure. I really, really loved it. It's music that you can just kind of get lost to, you know, and just kind of in your own thoughts. And even cooler to know that this is a concept, well, looking like a concept album. But yeah, this song is definitely a lot more Beatlesque. Even the title Bluebird, like mm-hmm. the Beatles song Bluebird.
Blackbird.
Or Blackbird, yeah. So very cool. I'm really, really enjoying this. This seems to be one of the most listened to songs.
Yeah, this so. One has a very, like, the way it's sounding, it has a very, like, Beatlesque way to it. And isn't it so cool that it's almost like you can kind of guess where he's going to land?
Yes.
When he's singing, like, da, 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 da. I don't know. You can kind of like make up your way, but then they do surprise you with a different note. And
yes.
Isn't that so cool?
I love it.
So you want to just like start over the song?
Sure.
I mean, just to give you the full experience. Mm-hmm. So we're going to start over, but the first one was definitely very cool. Very, very
yes.
Cool. All right, let's do it.
Thank you.
So it didn't bleed over. It kind of like started right away. What a great song. It was. I was going to say, what a effing great song. Youth
song. I agree. It really felt like a song that
I'm going to listen to it again.
I'm going to listen to it again, and a song that I feel like I should have listened to before. Very like the Beatles. Like, we're not huge connoisseurs, but we know the basics. Here comes the sun.
Yeah, Strawberry Fields.
You know, this feels like one of those that songs that I should have known.
That's true.
But beautiful. Definitely would listen to it again. I loved all the changes, how simple it was, but at the same time, very complex things that were like hidden in there. I really enjoyed it.
I love the whole like, bum 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 Yes. Super high. It was just so, such a showcase of the band. So that's what we can do. The drummer.
Yep.
Very cool. There was some electric guitar in there. The bass, I did not pay attention to.
I didn't either. Reason. I was fixated on the drums. The drums had a great, like, buffer, like, sound that didn't sound like, you know? I don't know. I
compact.
Very tight.
Yeah.
I like that.
I liked everything. The production was great. The arrangement was great. The song, I mean, the singing, the whole thing felt like a great package of like, this is like ELO. Listen to this. And then you're like, okay.
Yep. Yeah.
And I think that's why it's also so popular. It's very easy to listen to, very easy to get into. And it was just very catchy.
Yep.
Even though it was complex.
Yes, right? Exactly.
But like you say,
they managed to carry it out both ways very, very well. I can't wait for the next song. Oh no, not Susan. Let's see,
let's see
what we have. I'm excited. I love doing marathons this way. We're just like letting it flow, you know?
I know.
I love it. Okay, here we go.
Okay, here we go. Thank you.
Okay, bass, I hear ya. It's very Asian, very mahi-mahi.
Yes, I was going to tell you that, well, we have like a little thing that we call mahi-mahi. I sing Alexia like Asian scales, Japanese scales, Chinese scales. And this one sounded very Oriental.
Yes, right? It did.
It was like, oh my God, you got to win.
Right away, I'm like, la da 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 da. I can smell the cherry blossoms.
So cool. Let's like return a little. Okay. I want to listen to that again.
Okay.
But it's just, I'm loving this whole thing. I love the band. The voice, maybe this is totally, I don't even know if you know this band, but there's a band from the 90s and they're called Smashing Pumpkins. Right? The voice?
Yeah, could he definitely. Sounds like
Billy Cobham? No, Billy Cobham is a drummer. Billy something would.
Okay.
Yeah. Billy Cobham, that's the drummer from Mahavishnu. Let's go.
Yeah.
Sounds very Beatle. I mean, mm-hmm. Beatlesque. Sorry. Thank you.
was crazy. The fact that we didn't pause just made it very special, I think. But obviously now there's so much to say. So.
I know. Just going back to the third song, yes. The mm-hmm. Oh No, Not Susan, mm-hmm. the ending reminded me so much like of Kansas. Mm-hmm. It was so,
oh, yeah.
Right? Very yes. progressive mm-hmm. and very classical, but then they in the new world mm-hmm. they had that again, that diddle 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 diddle. I love that part. It was so just classical, mm-hmm. orchestral. I love arpeggios, you know, and I just love the singer, and I love the whole band as a unison. It's just very unique sounding.
Yeah,
I mean, yes, it sounds a lot like the Beatles, mm-hmm. but.
But the just Beatles to even be able to say that is crazy. Because look, New World Rising, that one kind of reminded me the beginning of like Eleanor Rigby a little bit mm-hmm. when he's like, morning, morning.
Everything.
Very cinematic, very yeah. like I felt like it was in a play yeah, a little yeah. bit, like walking through the streets and just hearing all the noises and mm-hmm. yeah. Really transportive album. I feel like this video has been like an experience, totally. You know? So I love marathons like this. Thank you, Bird in Hand, because this is really special. Instead of jumping around is fun, but when you get some sort of continuity.
I know.
I mean, you know.
I know,
it's
I
like
love
when
it.
We do full albums.
So. Yeah, I think yeah. sometimes that's the way we should do it. But I mean, I understand people want to show us a lot of stuff mm-hmm. and they just like throw their own
of
little
course.
Marathons together.
Of course, which I
and
love.
That's so much fun. And I even have like some marathons now in my mind that I could show you, like mm-hmm. of like different pieces of music that kind of fit together and call it something.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that's going to come once I'm done with everything else. And once Alexia has more time. But yeah, this was great. This was amazing. Mm-hmm. Just amazing musicianship. And I know why this band is so loved.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Now I totally get it. Oh, is this the band that you said that if they would have stayed together, this is how they would have sounded like one of the band members? Is that what John Lennon said? Or
yeah. I think John Lennon said that if we would have stayed together, that's we would have ended.
Okay.
I'm not really sure. I'm not like, I don't want to quote anyone. I didn't say it, but I did read something. I said that I think that's what the Beatles would have sounded like, mm-hmm. and then somebody said that a producer, I don't think it was a Beatle,
okay,
that said that, but a producer of the Beatles was producing them, and but it's just like it has a lot. They're very inspired by the
yeah,
Beatles.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
can just hear
yeah.
it.
Yeah,
you know?
And that's not
but
a bad
they,
thing.
No,
they're still unique
on the contrary,
because they're not exactly
no,
the same.
No, they're just using these classical instruments the way the Beatles were using them, mm-hmm. and like Eleanor Rigby or mm-hmm. something more. Progressive. I want to
yes.
call it progressive because the Beatles, when
yes.
they started, were very
psychedelic
roll,
a little bit.
But then, no, they got
psychedelic.
They got very psychedelic mm-hmm. in like Yellow Submarine.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Or was it later? Like Sgt. Pepper.
I'm not, again, I'm
horrible. I don't really know the Beatles that well. We have to get more. I mean, what we've heard so far, two albums, was more like straightforward.
Mm-hmm.
Very beautiful structured mm-hmm. songs, but not too trippy. But then like stuff like Hey Jude or Strawberry mm-hmm. Fields or, you know, Magical Mystery Tour. You know that one?
No.
Oof.
No.
So good. Oh, I wish I could tell that to you. Maybe we could do a reaction.
We can.
Yeah. The Magical Mystery Tour is coming to take you away.
No.
Coming to take you away. No?
No.
You've not? Oh, no. Because that is such an epic song for me because when I left Mexico on this plane from Mexico City towards Germany, you could hook up your headphones, right? Like mm-hmm. if you had headphones, mm-hmm. you could put in like in the radio station, and the entire plane had that. There were no screens, but it was
yeah.
just, so when I put it in that moment when it, because it was taking off, and it was like, ta-da, ta-da, welcome to the mystery tour.
Oh, that's
and
cool.
I'm like, that is such a cool song, and I had no idea it was the Beatles. And then 5, 6, 7 years later, I found out that was a Beatles song.
Wow, that's awesome.
And I was like, oh my God, I remember this song, and I've always wanted to know what it was. There was no, we didn't have a phone who would recognize a song. or you could, I could not sing this song and like say, hey, what is this song?
Mm-hmm.
So it was just in my head for like all these years. So I'm going to play it to you one day.
Okay, let's do it.
Remind us.
I'm down. Thank you, Bird in Hand. Thank you all for joining us, for spending this time with us, sharing your time with us to listen to some good tunes. We really appreciate having you all of here in the community that we've built. It really is special what we've created, and we're so grateful to you all. So thank you all so much. Consider liking, disliking, subscribing.
Unsubscribing.
Thank you all so much, and we hope to see you in the next
one. Thank you, guys.
Bye, everyone. Bye.